Hello YouTube and welcome to the next route learning video. On today's journey we're going to be travelling on the Liverpool to Manchester route from Liverpool Lime Street to Manchester Piccadilly, and we're going to be calling at Liverpool South Parkway, Widnes, Warrington Central, Manchester Oxford Road and Manchester Piccadilly. Our attraction for the journey today is a Class 158. These have been in service since 1989 and they were constructed between 1989 and 1992 by Brell at Derby Works. There were a total of 182 of these train sets built, of which 30 were converted to Class 159s, and there are 2 or 3 cars per train set. The maximum speed of these units is 90 miles per hour and the total weight is 38.5 tons per coach. There is one engine per coach with a power output of 350 or 400 horsepower depending upon the engine. The cab of the Class 158 is similar to other British Rail DMUs, so once we've put the train into forward and turned on the instrument lights, which I've already turned on, the headlights were already on for this journey. The only controls that we really need to worry about are the horn. I've got the Armstrong Powerhouse sound pack, so again I have 2-tone control of the horn with both the space bar and the B key. We have a 7-step power controller, from steps 1 through to 7 there. And we also have a standard Westcode 3-step brake. So we've got brake position 1, 2 and then 3, which is full service, and finally emergency. Though I try not to use above step 2 when I'm driving a train, as you'll see from my other videos. As this is my first video of the new year, I would just like to wish all of my subscribers and viewers a very happy 2015. Departing Liverpool Lime Street, the starting speed limit is 15 miles per hour. And we've got just under 5¾ miles to go to the next stop, which is Liverpool South Parkway. Now we're at 15 miles per hour, I've shut off power to allow the train to coast until we're able to accelerate further. Speed limit is now going up to 40 miles per hour. So as we enter this short tunnel bit here, just as we get close to the other end, I'm going to go into full power. As we reach 40 miles per hour, I've now shut down the power by 1 to step 6, which should maintain us at around 40 as we are currently going on a 1 in 93 upward gradient. Probably just saw from the signal there was a feather pointing right, which means we are going over some points. Now going to shut off power to allow the train to slow down towards 30 miles per hour, which is the speed limit across these points. In fact, I'm applying one step of braking, just to ensure that we don't break that speed. Now at 30 miles per hour, I'm going to go up to step 5 of power, which should hold us at roughly that speed. I've now shut off power as we're going through Edge Hill. Just at the other end of the station, we will be crossing some points to the right on which the speed limit is 25 miles per hour. So just as we reach the end of the platform here at Edge Hill, I'm just going to brake slightly to ensure that we're below 25 in time for the points. Once across the points, the speed limit is going back up to 30 miles per hour. And step 4 of power should hold us around that speed. See, the speed limit is now going up to 80 miles per hour, so I'm going to accelerate just as we reach this overhead wire gantry. Now we've passed it, I'm going to go into full power. Speed limit will shortly be dropping to 70 miles per hour through the next station. So as we reach 70, I'm just going to shut off power and temporarily coast. And we're actually going downhill slightly, so I'm just going to apply a step of braking to ensure that we don't break the speed limit. So this is Mosley Hill or Mosley Hill. I'm not quite sure which way to pronounce it. I was given two pronunciations earlier. So if you do know how to pronounce it, then please do let me know in the comments. Speed limit has now gone back up to 80 miles per hour. now have a flashing double yellow signal aspect, which is approach control signalling, as we'll be turning off this route just after Liverpool South Parkway. We're now passing through West Allerton Station. As we reach 75 miles per hour, I'm now going to shut off power and allow the train to coast. The braking point for Liverpool South Parkway station is at the next signal, which will be a flashing single yellow aspect. I'm now going to brake step 2. One problem with this route is that on stations with stop markers, they only seem to have a 4-car stop marker or above. There doesn't seem to be a 2-car stop marker for 2-coach trains. So I'm sort of having to guess where the stopping point would be. Here at Liverpool South Parkway, I'm going to stop just beyond the roof, just as the fence starts on the left there. Departing Liverpool South Parkway, the speed limit is quickly down to 20 miles per hour, and we've got just over 6.5 miles to go to the next stop, which is Widnes. So now we've reached 20 miles per hour, I've shut off power to allow the train to coast until we can accelerate further. Speed limit is now going up to 30 miles per hour, and I will accelerate at the next overhead gantry that we go under. So I'm going to accelerate now. Once again, as we reach 30 miles per hour, I'm going to shut off power to allow the train to coast. And as we join the line on the right, just coming up at the junction, the speed limit will then go up to 85 miles per hour. However, there is no speed board here, so we'll just need to know that once the rear of the train has cleared these points, we're able to accelerate. Interesting to note that the line we're joining has a third rail. It's actually part of the Mersey rail system. I believe that the Mersey rail system is the only part of the railway outside of London and the South East which is electrified on the third rail system. Passing through Hunt's Cross Station, which is where the third rail of the Mersey rail system ends. are passing through Halewood Station. As we reach 85 miles per hour in this train, if we go down one step in power to step 6, it will actually maintain us at just below 85 miles per hour, which makes this a fairly easy train for this route to maintain speed. Passing through Halgreen Station, and at the next signal after this station, that's actually a landmark, which is 1 mile from our stop at Widnes. Reached the signal, which means we're a mile from our stop, and now going to shut off power and just allow the train to coast. So if we look at the buildings that we're passing on the left, the braking point for Widnes is just after the last building. We've now passed that, so I'm now going to apply the brakes to step 2. Again, there is no clear stop marker here at Widnes, so I'm going to try and stop by the ticket machine just coming up on the left, as I'm not sure exactly where to stop. Departing Widnes, the starting speed limit is still 85 miles per hour. We've got just over 6 miles to go to the next stop, which is Warrington Central. once again, as we reach 85 miles per hour, I'm going to shut down the power to step 6, which will maintain us at around that speed. Passing through Sankey for Penketh Station. AWS for a Morpeth board, which will be coming up shortly, warning us of a speed reduction to 50 miles per hour. So now going to shut off power and brake. The warning is just over half a mile from the limit itself. We'll shortly have a further speed reduction down to 40 miles per hour. So I'm allowing the train to continue to coast. And I will brake lightly as we see the 40 mile per hour speed board, which I can just see in the distance there. So I'm now going to apply one step of braking. Now we're at the 40 mile per hour speed limit. We're going to continue to coast here, as we will shortly be arriving at Warrington Central. We've just crossed the West Coast Main Line, which is the line from London to Glasgow. And for Warrington Central, if we look ahead, we'll see the platforms, which will actually have a wall on each side. And as soon as I can see the platforms, I will brake. We can now see the platform just ahead, so I'm going into step 2 braking. Once again, I'm not sure of the exact stopping point here. So I'm going to stop just a little bit further up, towards the end of the roof. Starting Warrington Central, the starting speed limit is 75 miles per hour, and we've got around 15 and 3/4 miles to go to the next stop, which is Manchester Oxford Road. Coming up on the next right-hand curve, the speed limit will be dropping temporarily to 65 miles per hour. So once we reach 65, I'm going to shut off power and coast until the line speed returns to the full 85 mile per hour speed limit. Now entering 65 mile per hour speed zone. I'm going to shut off power. Because we're doing slightly below 65, as soon as we reach the 85 speed board, we can go straight into full power. The speed limit has now gone up to 85 miles per hour. We're now passing through Padgate Station. Passing through Birchwood Station. Once again, as we reach 85 miles per hour, I will reduce the power by one step to step 6, which will ensure that we don't break the speed limit. Passing through Glazebrook Station. Passing through Earlham. Just after we cross the bridge just ahead, we'll actually start going downhill on a gradient of 1 in 135, which will cause us to gain some speed. So I've idled the power here before we cross the bridge in the hopes that on the downhill section I won't have to use any braking to control the speed. So as you can see, we've now slowed down to 80 miles per hour. We are now on the downhill gradient of 1 in 135, which levels out as we pass through the next station. As the gradient levels out through Flixton Station here, I will now go up to Step 6 power once again. Passing through Chesson Road. We're now passing through Ermston. And as you can see, the stations along here are fairly close together, so I am planning on making some more videos on this route covering stopping services, which have a completely different feel to them to the express service I'm driving here. Passing Humphrey Park. We're now passing through Trafford Park Station. Shortly in front of us, we will be seeing Old Trafford, which is Manchester United's football stadium. You can now see it in front. Shortly after that, we'll be passing Manchester United's football stadium's railway station. Sorry, I got the words jumbled for a second there. The platform at Manchester United railway station is only on the left. There is only one platform, and it's not accessible from this direction. Passing the football ground railway station, and we have a warning for a drop in speed to 30 miles per hour, which is around a mile from the limit itself. I'm going to break step 2 for the 30 limit at the next signal just coming up. Now entering the 30 mile per hour speed zone. Now at 30 miles per hour, I'm going to use step 4 power to try and maintain that speed. Speed limit will shortly be dropping to 25 miles per hour, so I'm shutting off power to allow the train to coast. And I'll brake for 25, I believe it's on the sharp right curve just coming up. Correction to that, it's on the next sharp right curve. So I'm now going to brake step 1 to ensure that we're slowed down to 25 miles per hour. We're now entering the 25 mile per hour speed zone. And just after we join this line here, the speed limit is going up to 35. We can accelerate at the next overhead wire gantry. And the station just ahead we're about to pass through is Deansgate. Reached 35, I've shut off power to allow the train to coast, and I will be braking very shortly at the next set of points just coming up, as the speed limit is dropping down to 20 miles per hour. We're now approaching Manchester Oxford Road. Again, I'm not sure of the stopping point here, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop just before the first signal in the platform here, as there are actually two signals that I can see. And I'm going to hope that this is the right place to stop. Starting Manchester Oxford Road, the starting speed limit is 20 miles per hour. We've got around 2/3 of a mile to go to our final stop, which is Manchester Piccadilly. So I've just shut off power at 20 for a few seconds. We can accelerate now to 35 miles per hour at the end of this point. as we reach 35 miles per hour or close to that, I'm going to idle for power. And by that time we'll be getting pretty close to Manchester Piccadilly. Now idling the power at 35 miles per hour, and I'm going to brake step 1 just after this signal that we're about to pass. I'm now applying the brakes for a speed reduction to 20 miles per hour once again. Did brake just slightly too early there. We're now approaching Manchester Piccadilly. Again, I'm not sure where the stopping point is, so I'm going to assume just before the first signal we see just coming up. Manchester Piccadilly station that we're stopping at here is the same station as Manchester London Road on the Woodhead line. It was renamed Piccadilly, I believe, in the 1960s. Thanks for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed the video.